Okay, if you're running a small business and you want to calculate depreciation, you might find this fixed asset schedule to be useful. What we're going to do is we're going to walk through how to use it by just stepping through these examples that I have on here and explaining what's happening. And as we go through this, you can grab this file if you want and just walk through it along with the video. You can make a copy of it, put it in your own drive, and do anything you want with it. It can be yours. And there's also an affiliate link there to G Suite, which is Google's offering of Google Sheets, Docs, Gmail for your business. So you can use your own custom email address with Gmail if you're interested. Check it out. So let's act like you went out, you bought a bandsaw in February 2018. Okay, you come in here, you give it a sequential number, give it a description, and you write down the date it was placed in service. So far, none of these are driving a formula. Okay, so you're just typing it in for your reference. And we're going to come back to a disposal date because you haven't done that yet. Let's look at the journal entry up to this point. Assuming you're not doing accrual basis accounting, you're just doing cash, what you did was you debited equipment for $2103 and you spent $2103 in cash to get it. All right, so let's come up. We're at that point. Here's the $2103. And we complete the month of February. We're going to use a convention for this, just saying, hey, let's just depreciate for the full month that you put the asset in, so don't bother prorating it. It's going to wash out. So we do one full month in February, and this is where a formula comes in. So I'm going to double click on the cell, and it's going to show us that I'm using the straight line formula, SLN. There are formulas that have accelerated methods of depreciation, but as long as you're doing internal record keeping, you're typically not going to want to use those. The arguments that straight line looks for is if we left click on the formula, Google will tell us what it's looking for. So it needs the cost. So what I've done here is I've put in a fixed column cell reference that looks at the cost. And I put that dollar sign before the E7 so that when we drag this formula to the right to calculate subsequent months, it's still looking at column E. Did the same thing with salvage value. In this case, we say, look, this has no salvage value. We're going to use the bandsaw. When we're done with it, we're probably going to have to recycle it. And then it looks for the life. And you'll notice I use the life in months. That way you can do it for every month because you're typically not putting it in right on January 1st. So I'm going to hit the escape key and get out of this. So what we've done so far is we've calculated 1 month of depreciation. Drag this formula to the right, which has already been done, but if you go into the cell and your cursor turns into a plus sign, then you can left click and drag it over. Going to scroll to the right and show you I depreciated this through July because I'm saying that we dispose of it on July 5th. So before we look at the disposal though, let's double click cell 2018. What these cells are doing for each year is that they're summing 12 months. So if I double click in 2018, it's going to grab all the depreciation for this asset, and it would have done it all the way through December had I not disposed of it. So that's going to give you monthly journal entries if you come over here and you would have summed those. Matter of fact, let's just do that live. Drag this formula over. Your depreciation expense for the month of February is $3,505. Let's scroll down to see how you would record that. You would debit depreciation expense for $3,505, and then you would credit accumulated depreciation because it has to go somewhere. So this creates a contra asset that reduces the net value of your fixed assets on your balance sheet. This is an income statement entry. This is a balance sheet entry. Let's scroll back up. So what happens next is in July, we just find out that we want to get rid of the asset for whatever reason. We're not getting any money for it. So let's come down here. And we're going to use this disposals row. Just copy the asset number and the description. Let's get rid of that too. That's bothering me. Say you dispose of it in July. Again, this July is not driving any formula. It's just as a reminder for when to shut off the depreciation. We're backing out the entire cost, taking it all off of the balance sheet. We don't undo the depreciation expense, but this is here to back out the accumulated. We'll come back to that in a second. And this is just showing that the net book value of what you got rid of was $1,893. So I know this is a little bit complicated to understand, but bear with me. And if we scroll down, these are the numbers that you should end up with at the end of the year on your balance sheet and your income statement. But before we talk about the end of the year entries, we need to record the disposal of asset number one. So you need to back out the entire amount of the cost of the equipment, and then you're backing out the accumulated depreciation. So the accumulated, if we go back up, is right here. Back that out by debiting it. So if you look at the accumulated, you would have credited 210.30 through July for it. So this is going to wipe out the accumulated associated with that asset. And then you have to book a loss on disposal because you got nothing for it, but it wasn't worth 2103. You already spent some of it. So you're saying some of it already wore out. Say, look, it's really a $1,900 loss. So that would be your journal entry in July. You come back up here. Last thing to see is that it's kind of plugged in at the end here because it has to roll forward. So the accumulated at the end of 2018 is what you start with in 2019. And then you add the depreciation expense onto it. And then this is what you should end with in 2019, assuming you didn't dispose of anything else and you didn't add anything else. These formulas are kind of lightweight and they're meant to be that way just to keep us flexible, because I'm sure whoever uses it is going to use it a little bit differently. You're going to have to add years. You'll have to pull things down as you add more assets. And you should be able to click in these formulas and kind of figure out what to do. So they're just a sum formula. And the most complicated formula in here is a straight line. And that's not too bad either. So I hope that was helpful. If you want to see another Google Sheets accounting video, we have one thumbnail that should be showing right now that shows you how to track inventory for small business. And if you like this video, it'd be great if you could subscribe. Thanks.